Hi, my name is José Manuel Ortega, and this presentation is about the monitoring and managing containers using open source tools. My name is José Ortega, I'm from Spain, and in the last year I'm interested in DevOps with focus on security. You can follow me in Twitter and LinkedIn, where I usually share content related with security, hacking, ethical hacking, Python, and containers. Also, I am technical writer, and this year I have published a book related with DevOps and container security, with focus in Docker and Kubernetes tools ecosystem. This is the book I have published with BPB Editorial. In this book, basically, you can learn about Docker as a platform for the deployment of containers and Docker image, taking into account the security of applications. Also, you can learn some specific tools about monitoring and administration in Docker, so with tools such as CAdvisor, Sysdig, Portainer, and Rancher. This could be the main points to discuss in this talk. Basically, we are going to talk about challenging containers and architectures distributed from the point of view of monitoring and administration. Most important metrics that we can use to measure container performance. Later we will review the main tools for monitoring and management of containers such as CAdvisor, Sysdig, and Pointainer, and we will make a little introduction to Rancher as a platform for administration for Kubernetes. Well, the question at this point is why do we need to monitor our Docker containers? Well, it is obvious that monitoring is an essential part of Docker-based environments. Among the main reasons we need to monitor our containers, we can highlight detecting issues and troubles at an early stage to avoid risks at a production level. Changes and upgrades can be done in a secure way as the whole environment is tracked. Another reason that we can find is refine or refactor our applications for better performance and robustness in general when we are deploying our application in different environments. Well, monitoring containers are one of the most challenging activities related to container-based applications. Monitoring applications performance ensures that both the containerized applications and infrastructure are always at optimum levels. For example, monitoring historical data and CPU usage are useful to recognize trends that lead to recurring issues or bottlenecks. The idea is to analyze some tools for Docker monitoring that provide a dashboard for visualizing data per container, like CPU, memory, and network. The sense of monitoring philosophy is to ensure that a running process is performing to the expected level. Among the main metrics we can highlight the use of CPU, memory, input, output, network requests, and in general the network traffic that we can monitor with specific tools like TCP DAM or Wireshark. We can use these metrics for measure the performance of our application. The Docker engine itself provides access to most of the core metrics we are looking to collect as part of its native monitoring functions. And for example, running the simple command docker stats will give you access to CPU, memory, network, and disk utilization for all the containers running on your Docker host. In this way, Docker Stats achieves this by picking up metrics directly from the Docker daemon. That is the main process that Docker runs for creating the different the different containers from an image. Docker Stats basically shows the percentage of CPU utilization for each container, the memory use and total memory available to the container, added to that we can see total data sent and received over the network by the container. These statistics can be used to see the behavior of containers during execution, and the information can be useful to verify we need some restrictions on the resources that we will apply to the containers. Docker Daemon also provides a remote REST API. This API is used by the client to communicate with the Docker engine and can also be invoked by other tools such as Cure or Postman REST client. And basically the API provides an stats endpoint, and we can use it with the container ID or the name of the container to invoke this endpoint. For example, we could use the stats endpoint using the container ID in the URL, and in this way we are obtaining the container statistics in JSON format by default, and in the return information you can get detailed information for memory users as well as information about the CPU. If we continue with review the main tools that we have in the Docker ecosystem, one of the most on the most known is ShareVisor, that is a container monitoring tool from Google with native support for Docker containers. Basically, it's a daemon that collects, aggregates, processes, and exports information about running containers. ShareVisor is easy to get up and running, as it can be deployed in a single Docker container. All you have to do is run this Docker run command to execute a ShareVisor container and expose the web interface on port 8080. And once launched, ShareVisor will hook itself into the Docker daemon running on your host machine and start gathering metrics for all of your running containers, including the ShareVisor container itself. The best way to think of a ShareVisor is that basically it's a graphical version of what you get when you execute the Docker stats we have seen before. Basically, ShareVisor is the graphical version of Docker stats. Among other things, ShareVisor is allow you to monitor resource isolation parameters, historical resource usage, and network statistics. ShareVisor is a very useful tool that it can be set up in an easy way to discover the resources consumption by the containers applications. For example, we can display the graphs related to the CPU, memory usage, network input, output, and this space utilization. ShareVisor dashboard shows data for the last 60 seconds only. However, multiple backends such as Prometheus and InfluxDB are supported that allows long-term storage, retrieval, and analysis. ShareVisor provides both a web UI and REST API to monitor Docker containers directly, as well as integrate metrics to an external application via web service endpoints. In the Docker container sections, you can see the URLs of the containers that are running on the Docker host, and if you click on any of them, you will see the resource usage information for the corresponding container. In the Docker ecosystem, we can find other tools. For example, CTOP, that is a tool developed in Golang that provides an overview of real-time metrics for multiple containers in a graphical way. Other interesting tools like for Docker monitoring is LazyDocker, that is a terminal user interface for both Docker and Docker Compose writing in Golang. And another interesting tool that is not related directly with monitoring, but for example, if you need to explore a Docker image layer by layer, you can use this tool. It's called Dive. This tool allows us to explore Docker image, the content of each layer that make up the layer image, as well as the size and persistence of image efficiency. For example, you could show chunks in the file system for each layer and estimate image efficiency for tasks related with analyzing the size of image. When selecting a specific layer inside an image, we can see the layer details and the folder structures of this layer. Also, we can see information related with the command that is generating that layer, image size, potential wasted space, and image efficiency score. We continue with other interesting tools. In this case, we are going to review what provides the 6D. 6D is a startup related with that has many tools related with monitoring, analyzing the security of containers. Basically, 6D claims the most in-depth integration within the Docker ecosystems and trust data directly from container metadata to enable security and Docker monitoring. And from the point of view of monitoring, Docker containers with this tool, we can control the behavior of containers. 6D works by capturing system calls that are made within the Linux kernel. This provides 6D with visibility into how applications work with containers. 6D, this is the architecture, can operate both with real-time data and previously captured data, and is installed as an agent on each host, which takes advantage of system calls and kernel filters, again rules, in a signature database to identify suspicious activity or anomalies inside the containers. And from the monitoring point of view, the 6D provides some specific tools for helping these tasks. One of the open source tools we can find is called C6D. These tools allows you to analyze and capture the system calls of various types of containers, such as Docker and Linux containers, and the underlying processes and threads, along with the use of resources at the CPU, memory, and network levels. This tool shows all containers running on the host, and you can drill down into a container to see what resources individual processes are consuming in a specific container. Another interesting tool that provides 6D is called Falco. This is a solution that allows this solution is oriented to container security monitoring. Falco is the default, for example, is the default Kubernetes threat detection engine, and has the capacity for detecting and inspected application behavior and alerts on threats at runtime. Falco allows you to monitor a container, application, host, and network activity, just as we would do with a combination of Unix tools such as Snort, tcpdump, and Strace. Basically, Falco combines all these tools in a in a specific command. As we can see in this screenshot, it provides a rich set of default events, sys calls, and filters, unless you customize the rules for them. With the following command, for example, we are obtaining all the containers in execution, and internally, what it does these tools is identify the system calls execute in different user namespaces, and reports the name of the container for each namespace. The interesting thing about Sysdig is the ability to filter based on information from the Docker container, and at this point it provides filters available to inform about system status, application protocols such as HTTP or main cache, CPU usage, and network activity. When trying to inspect, for example, when trying to inspect network traffic in a similar way, we can use tools like tcpdump. We could use Falco with the HTTP log command for monitoring HTTP requests from containers. We could also filter all the system calls executed by Apache and MySQL processes, indicating with the proc.name property the names of the processes that we want to filter. Well, to take the full advantage of container benefits, organizations need the appropriate management and administration tools that allow them to manage the full life cycle of the container and ensure the availability for both development and production environments. Within the Docker ecosystem, we can find some interesting tools for developers for managing image and containers. Among the main tools for containers administration, we can highlight Rancher and Portainer. These tools are similar. Portainer is focused on manage the life cycle of your image and containers with Docker, and Rancher is more focused in administration not only the containers, also your cluster and so on. Among the main advantages that Rancher offers, we can highlight it allows you to create as many environments as you need and manage users and roles in different environments. Also, it allows you to select the container orchestrator from several such as Mesos, Kubernetes, or Docker Swarm. It provides more flexibility to administrate your cluster. Rancher basically provides a web interface to control containers, and the main dashboard shows starting, stop, and running containers. The best of Rancher is that provides a user interface with a lot of many options for administrate your containers and creating an environment where your containers will be executed in a with high availability and with high performance. The containers, this is another screen capture where we can see the container sections that list all your running containers. For example, you can open a shell into a container and do other actions like stop, restart, and delete the container, and other options like view logs and clone the containers. It provides many options to manage the life cycle of your containers. And the second tool I'm going to comment is Portainer. This tool basically allows you to manage your containers, image, volumes, networks with an user interface that allows you to manage the different Docker environments. In the same way that we execute a Docker pull or Docker run from the terminal, with this tool we can do it from a graphical interface, as we can as we will see now. Portainer can be executed as a lightweight Docker container on top of a Docker host or Swagger Docker cluster. We can actually run a Portainer as a container, which give us the added benefit of being able to experiment without worry about installation and dependencies. And starting Portainer as a container using the Docker CLI is as simple as executing a Docker run or using Docker Compose configuring or Docker Compose YAML. In this file, we can highlight some options like creating a volume named Portainer Data for persistent storage. And also in the Docker Compose, we can see that we are forwarding TCP port 900 from the host to ship to TCP port 900 in our container from accessing the using interface. The first time we are configuring Portainer, let us choose the type of connection we can use for handling the container. We can choose between different installation types like local or remote Docker environment. Also, we can use a Portainer agent or connecting with other cloud providers like Azure. This is the main board, the main dashboard, where we can see containers, image, and services that are running in the Docker environment we have selected and have cre been created in the Docker instance. On the containers list section, we can see each hour of our running containers along with some basic information about each one. In this section, we are able to execute several instructions that we usually execute through the command line, such as starting, stopping, or deleting the container. Clicking on a container name will drill down into the container details section and give you a lot of information about it, while also allowing you to create a new image based on your container or change other settings. At the top of we have different actions like start, stop, kill, restart, pause, resume, and remove. And at the bottom, we have links for view all the information for logs, inspect, and start execute or other commands that are available in the Docker daemon. Here we can see, for example, details of a container like port configuration, environment variables, and labels. In the volume section, we can see a list of our volumes where we are able to remove them or add new ones. And for each volume, we can see the name, the star, the driver, mount point, and so on. In network settings, we can see a list of all the Docker networks that have been created with details about each. In the image section, we can see a list of images on your Docker instance. Also, we can create and manage our own image, for example, pulling an image from the Docker Hub registry. And clicking on an image will take you to the image details, which will show you a lot of the details about each image. In container statistics section, also we can see the use of CPU, memory, and network. Portainer is compatible with the Docker Engine and Docker Swarm. And if you want to test Portainer, Katacoda provides an scenario for deploying Portainer to Docker Swarm cluster. Basically, you need first to deploy a Docker Swarm cluster, And over this cluster, you can execute portainer for testing, for deploying a container with high ability over this cluster, and testing this, monitoring this container with the portainer user interface. And finally, for conclusions, we can see that all of the tools we have covered, we will be able to get you started with container visibility and monitoring. And the objective is to keep an open eye, so what is going inside these containers in order to optimize our applications and systems, and choosing the best monitoring solutions. The best monitoring solution depends on the combination of tools that we have, our challenge, and our needs. And it's up to you to decide what combination of tools is needed to collect information that will help your monitor and optimize your applications and systems. The tools I have commented in this presentation are not maybe can be not the best for your needs, but I have tried to review the best open source tools that you can use in your projects. And for conclude, if you want to know more, there are some books that related with this topic. Was for example, Monitoring Docker. This book will show you how monitoring Docker containers with some of the tools we have reviewed in this presentation. And that's all. Thank you to the audience and the organization. If you have any questions, you can do it through the organization, and I will try to answer the question. Thank you very much. Bye.